record the session from my side and let me share the screen. Right, okay. So is it clear? So we will get, okay, recording. Vishnu, you didn't get the recording permission. Okay, I give you the recording permissions, Vishnu. Yes, okay. So if you install a SQL Server software, okay, for the first time, you will get both specific services and shared services. Okay. So in our case, I haven't installed analysis services, reporting services. Okay. So you cannot see these two services. If you install the extra components of analysis and reporting services, these services also will act as a specific service, means one copy will exist per instance. Per instance, okay, that is per instance, and this is per Windows server, right? If you install 3 or 4 SQL servers in your machine, okay, but still these three services are in our case, it is 2017, right? Up to SQL Server 2016, like from SQL Server 2017, okay, before SQL Server 2017. So in our case, okay, as we install SQL Server 2017, okay, you will get the browser service and VSS writer service as a shared services, okay, in our case now, okay. Apart from these shared services, we also get the database engine service, we also get the agent service, and we also get the full text service, and we also get the CIP service, okay. Right, now how to identify which is a shared service, which is a specific service? Can anyone tell me? How to identify which is a shared service and which is a specific service? You can easily identify. Just apply common sense. That's it.
The one with the backslash is a shared one, and anti-service backslash equal server agent. These are the.
Very good. That is one more shortcut. Good. Right. Okay. A simple shortcut is you can see the name of the instance in the brackets. So if you are staying in a PZ, imagine you are staying in a PZ, okay? The things which belongs to you, usually you will have your name on the things. Mostly, this is a common practice, right? On the washing machine, you don't find any name. Why? Because that is a shared property that belongs to the PZ owner, right? So the things that belongs to you, you will have a name on those things, right? To make sure those things belongs to you only. Okay, the common properties like washing machine and will have different common properties will be there, Wi-Fi router. On these things, you don't find any name. Why? Because those belongs to a shared property. So you don't find any name. Got it? So on specific services, you will have name in the brackets. On shared services, you don't see any name in the brackets. Okay, to avoid the duplication for specific services, you will have a name, means you can have one more full text service with a different name. You can have one more SQL Server main service. This is the main service, guys. This is the main service. If your SQL Server is not running, if you are unable to connect to the SQL Server, just check whether SQL Server, which is in the brackets, you can find the instance name, is running or not. This is the main service. This is the heart of the SQL Server and everything of the SQL Server, database engine service, okay? And this is the agent service and browser service, and you will have your CIP service and VSS writer service. Okay, so the name, if you see the name in the brackets, okay, so you can identify those services belongs to a specific service. If you don't see any name in the brackets like browser service and VSS writer, those are all shared services. Again, if you install, now tell me, if I install SQL Server for the first time, I got 6 services. In that, 4 are specific services and 2 are shared services. Now tell me, if I install 2 instances, how many services I'll get?
Sorry, can you repeat the question?
Yes. If you install one more instance, 2 instances in the Windows Server, how many services I'll get now?
10 services.
Yeah, generally we get like a 6.
For one instance, I got 6 services, 4 are specific, 2 are shared. Okay.
Yeah. Now yeah. 8.
For 2 instances, how many services, how many total services I'll get?
8.
Is it, honey?
I think so.
SQL server and SQL server.
Okay. Plus 4. Very good, Srikant. Plus 4. Okay. So the answer is, okay, in 6 services, okay, for the first time you'll get 6 services, right? 6 services. In that 4 are specific and 2 are shared, okay?
Shared. Oh, yeah. 2 are shared. I thought 4 are shared.
No. Only 2 are shared, okay?
Okay.
So if you install one more instance, shared won't be installed again. Shared services won't be installed again. Yeah. Again, you will get 10. 4 more specific services.
Yeah.
So total 4 plus 10. 4 plus 2. 10. Okay, it will be 10 services will be configured once you install. Now tell me 5 instances I have installed.
Twenty-two.
Okay, 4 and plus 2. This is the formula, okay? N means number of services, number of instances. Okay, if you install 5 instances, 4 into 5 plus 2, 22 services you will get. Okay, clear?
And Sean, just a quick question here.
Yes.
If you can just minimize this, not bad.
Okay.
So, for example, if we are installing 2 servers, maybe on one virtual machine, mm-hmm. You know, so for example, if something wrong happened with our one server, but mm-hmm. the service is shared, right? Maybe I have to restart SQL Server Engine. So when I restart the shared service, it will automatically restart for the other server as well, which is not affected, right?
Yes.
In a way.
Usually 99% in case if something happened to the server, we are going to restart the main database engine service. As the database engine service is specific for each instance, so the other instance is not going to be affected.
Okay.
Got it?
And the agent one as well.
Yes, agent one as well. Once you, agent will depends on the database engine service. Okay. If you restart the database engine or SQL Server service, automatically agent will also go for a restart. It will ask us to restart the agent service as well.
And what does the SQL Server CEIP service do?
CEIP usually, so this is like a new service introduced from SQL Server 2017. I didn't check what CEIP service will do. I'll update you what this service will do, okay?
Okay, so yeah. Is it possible for you to tell us as well, like, you know, if something goes wrong, which service we have to restart kind of thing, because there are 6 services,
yes,
but
yes,
not
yes.
every time.
Yes, we that's gonna, why.
You know,
so the main yeah. service is this one. Okay, this is main service, SQL Server. Okay, you cannot see any other name, just SQL Server. In the brackets, you can see instance name. Imagine you have installed 2 instances, okay? One is Honey, one is MS SQL
yes.
Server. Something
yes.
happened to the Honey instance, then you can only yes. restart the Honey instance.
Right.
Okay, so the services that depends upon the Honey instance also will be restarted automatically.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah, cool.
Yeah.
And do update me for the VSS writer as well.
Like VSS CIPM. Writer, so it will help you to write the data from the, to the disk. It is going to write the data to the physical disks. We are going to store the data in the drives, right? D drive, E drive, F drive, in the different drives, we are going to share the data, right? So we are
yeah.
going to save the data to the drives permanently, right? So why we are going to save the data, to store the data permanently? In case if the machine is rebooted, the data won't go anywhere, right? The VSS writer will write the data to the disk permanently.
And at any time, do we have to restart this?
No, not required.
Case,
not
any...
required.
Okay.
Usually what we do is, yes, in case if something happened, you are going to directly reboot the Windows server, all services are going to be restarted. The
yeah,
whole Windows machine,
yeah.
yes.
And that full text filter daemon launcher.
Full text filter, yes. Full text filter, what it will do is, it is going to help you to search the data, to filter the data. This service
okay,
will help
sir.
You to search the data in the SQL. Imagine you have a 1 lakh records, okay, in right. the table. Now you want to search those who are 1 lakh employees record. Now you want to search those who are working from Australia. You can use where condition, right, in the query. So this full yeah. text will help you to filter the data, to search the data.
So in a nutshell, we have the full text filter, SQL okay. Server, SQL Server Agent, and the CEIP. They are specific to server
yes.
and server browser and VSS Writer. VSS they are writer. Shared one.
Shared one.
They
yes.
shared one.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Makes
okay.
Sense.
Yeah. That's yeah. fine. Any other questions, please? Right. Okay. Fine. Right. Now the formula is 4n plus 2. Now tell me one answer. Okay. I have installed three SQL services, three SQL servers, okay, with two reporting services, okay. Now tell me how many total services I will get. Three SQL servers with two reporting services. Customers asked to install reporting services as well. How many services I will get totally? How many shared? How many specific? You got my question, I guess. Three SQL servers with two reporting services. How many services 16? I'll get now? Okay.
So in one reporting server, I don't know, you know, how many services we get when we install one reporting service.
No, no, only one reporting service we'll get. You will get only one reporting service. If you install okay, reporting services, yeah. Two. Yes, two reporting services. Okay. Yeah. Okay, reporting services is specific
one or not?
Specific. Okay. If you see here, these are the specific services. Analysis.
16.
Yes. Okay, and let me introduce one more thing. SQL Server integration services. Integration services are shared services. Okay, so if you install SQL Server SSIS, SSAS and SSRS are specific services. SSAS is a shared service, okay? Even though you install two or three integration services, but you won't get that chance once you install an integration service in a machine. No, you cannot install one more integration services, okay? You can only install one integration service per machine, for the whole Windows machine. Why? Because integration services is a shared services, okay? Now tell me, what is the answer for this? Three SQL servers with two reporting services. Same concept, 4n plus 2, okay? This is same, common, right? Plus two reporting services, right? Plus two again. So 4 into 3, 12 plus 4, okay? You will get 16 yeah, services 16. Totally, okay? So this is how we have to identify the differences between a shared service and a specific service, right? Good. Right, let me check the status of my, yeah, it was successfully, okay, installed. What it is asking is, it is asking for a restart of the machine. Let me restart the server, okay. Just restart the server, the whole Windows server, once you install Management Studio, otherwise your Management Studio won't work properly, okay. Right. How to find whether my machine is online or offline? How to find out? You just restarted your machine. Now you want to check whether the machine came online or not. How to check it? So we can go for a ping, okay? Ping test, okay? What is my machine IP address? 192.168.0.109, right? 109. Okay, just go for a ping test.
It's still not
okay.
online.
Yes. If you see request timed out, that means the machine doesn't come online, okay? If you see here, the machine is still restarting state. Okay, now it was restarted. Okay, now let's go with the same ping again. Okay.
You'll get the reply.
Yeah. Okay, let me log into this machine. One minute, please. Okay, it's now restarting now, okay? Let me go with the trace. -T will give you the trace, continuous trace, okay? Let's trace now. If you just give only ping IP address, it will tell you the four iterations. It will send four packets to the machine. If you don't get reply, you will get request timed out option, okay? So if the machine is restarted, you can see there is a different error, okay? Destination host unreachable, okay? Now you see, once the machine is rebooted completely, now you see the output. Okay, you will get a reply from that machine. Let the machine completely restarted. Okay, it is in still restarting state. It is restarting. Okay. Now you can see, once the machine is completely online, now you can get a reply from that machine.
Sir, can we use control delete right, sir?
Control delete. Yes, yes, of course. Right, control plus delete.
But directly we can do it, sir, without like this.
No, no, no. Directly we can log in. We can do whatever we want. But why I am doing it means, as a real time experience in the organization, once you go to the company, okay, they will give you the IP address or server name.
Okay.
Then if you don't know how to connect to the server, what is the use of 5 years of experience? Right, for that purpose we are going to, okay, practice from the day one onwards how to connect to the server remotely, how to use RDP, what we have to give, what you have to select once you give the username and password. Those things we have to discuss, right? That's what the real time setup. Okay, and it's still we are getting request timed out. Let's see. Okay, let it be. In the meanwhile, I'll log into the machine. Okay, same 192.168.0.109. Okay. 192.168.0. Oh, okay. I'm tracing 101, right? I'm sorry. Just control C will cancel the. Why you are getting reply from 109? I'm tracing 10. Okay. Let me try this one. Okay. Fine. Okay. So same IP address. Let it be. Why? Because sometimes you won't get the response. Okay. And remote desktop. Open remote desktop. Okay, and try to connect to the server. Okay, remotely 109. Right, just click yes. Right. Okay. Once you just restarted the Windows machine. Okay. Now what I have to do is I have to open the Management Studio. Okay. How to open the Management Studio? So I can open Management Studio in multiple ways. One way is, okay, just hit the Windows button. From SQL Server 2005 onwards, this Management Studio has been introduced. Before SQL Server 2005, we have one more version. What version we have before SQL Server 2005? SQL Server 2000. We have SQL Server 2000. For SQL Server 2000, there is no Management Studio, but still we can connect to the SQL Server 2000 instances using Query Analyzer. Okay. We can use Query Analyzer to connect to the SQL Server. Okay, we can use Query Analyzer to, like, it acts as a Management Studio only, but the name is different. Query Analyzer, you can use Query Analyzer. Why? Because still some of the companies are still using SQL Server 2000, so you have to know how to connect to the 2000 instances. So we are going to use Query Analyzer to connect to the SQL Server 2000 instance. From SQL Server 2005 onwards, Microsoft introduced this Management Studio. Okay, so the shortcut is SSMS. You have to run SSMS. For SQL Server 2005, some shortcuts are different. For SQL Server 2005, the shortcut is SQLWB. You have to open run and you have to type SQLWB for getting the Management Studio. From SQL Server 2008 onwards, okay, the shortcut is SSMS. Open run, type SSMS. This will work up to SQL Server 2016. This shortcut will work. Okay. From SQL Server 2017 onwards, SQL Server 2017 onwards, SSMS also won't work. If you go to the machine, if you type SSMS like this, sometimes you'll get the error like this. Okay. So what you have to do is simply, okay, hit the Windows button, just type SSM or SSMS. Okay. You can type SSM or SSMS. Then you can see the SQL Server 2000, SQL Server Management Studio 18. Okay. Sometimes in the interviews, they will ask you what is the latest version of Management Studio. Okay, so we cannot expect what kind of questions they are going to ask. You can simply say 18. Okay, actually the latest version is 18.9.1. Okay, you can simply say 18, version 18. Currently in the market, the recent version is 18. Okay, for SQL Server Management Studio, not for SQL Server. SQL Server is different, SQL Server Management Studio is different. Okay. Just wait a minute, okay? It will take some time for the first time. Right. Okay, fine. This is your management studio. Okay. This is your management studio. Right, fine. So if you see here, once you open the management studio, it will ask you to automatically, the screen will prompt. Okay. So it will ask you for the server name, which server I have to connect. Okay. You can see here, right? SQL Server. The first field is server type. If you want to connect to the database engine, or you want to connect to the analysis services, or you want to connect to the reporting services, or you want to connect to the integration services, or you want to come to the Azure integration runtime. Okay. So we are not going to discuss about this Azure and all. So in case if you install analysis services, reporting services, integration services, then you can first select, you want to connect to the analysis services. You can select analysis services and you can give the server name. You want to connect to the reporting services. Simply you have to select the reporting services from the drop down and you have to give the reporting services server name. Okay. But our work as a DBS, our work will be on database engine services. 99.99% we are going to spend our time on the database engine services only. So now we are going to connect to the database engine. Select the database engine now. Once you connect to the, once you selected the database engine, then it will ask you the server name. Why? Because we can install 50 instances, right? Imagine 50 students are there in a class. Now I want to call one student. Okay, now what I have to do, I have to call with his name or roll number, right? So as we are having multiple instances, it's important to give the server name here. In case if you don't give the server name, okay, how you are going to connect to the server? So you have to give the server name here. If you see the server name, actually this is your Windows machine name. How to find out a Windows machine name? I want to find out, forget about SQL Server name. How to find out a Windows machine name, Windows server name, how to find out? Okay. We have two ways for that. One is command prompt, open command prompt, type host name. Then you can find the machine name. Okay. This is the machine name, Windows server name, right? This is one way. The second way is go to this PC properties, this PC properties. There also you can see the server name, okay, computer name or server name, Win793. Okay, if you see here, same name will be there, okay. Win, yeah, you can see here, okay. Wins, you can compare this number and this number. Win793NNF84G1T. Okay, so the same name will be populated in the server name. Why I can see the computer name here? Why I can see the computer name here? I didn't give any instance name for the default instance, but why I can see the computer name here? Why? Can anyone tell me the answer?
Defaultly the computer name.
Very good. Okay. Always default instance. Okay, there is a difference between default instance and named instance. Default instance always pick the computer name. no need to give any name to the default instance. Okay, no need to give any name to the default instance. But how, without giving any name, how can it pick the name? It is going to pick the computer name. That's why we cannot install multiple default instances in a machine. Why? Because we don't have multiple computer names for a single server. Okay, only one computer name will be there, that will be allocated to the default instance. So you cannot install one more default instance of any version. Got it? So you want to like install SQL Server 2012 and SQL Server 2014 in the same Windows server. So if you install a default instance once, then it won't allow you to install one more default instance for 2014 as well. You cannot install one more default instance of 2012, and you cannot install one more instance of other version also. No default instance per version, only default instance per machine. That's why you can install only one default instance per machine and 49 named instances. Why? Because if you go for one more default instance, which name you are going to give? As the name is already occupied with the other default instance, it won't allow you for the duplication of the instance name. Imagine I have two Srikanths in this class. If I call, hey Srikanth, which one will respond? The best case is both will respond. The worst case is both won't respond. Right? So that's why duplication, conflict will arise. So that's why you cannot install one more default instance in a machine. You can install only one default instance in a machine, and it will pick up the computer name automatically. Authentication type, I will explain what is this authentication. Usually we'll have two types of authentications. One is Windows authentication, second one is SQL Server authentication. You can see here, okay, just as of now, on premises, you can see only two. These are latest, you can find these options in the latest management studio, okay? These are belongs to Azure, okay? Forget about these three things, and you can see Windows authentication and SQL Server authentication. We have a separate topic called security. We'll discuss what is an authentication, what is an authorization, what is a login, what is a user, what, how to give permissions. Okay, everything we'll discuss. There I'll tell you what Windows authentication will do, how it will work, what SQL Server authentication will do, how it will work. Usually, blindly, if you select Windows authentication, it won't ask you the username and password. But that doesn't mean everyone can log in. Username will be auto-populated. Why I can see the username here? Can anyone tell me why I can see the administrator username here? Why? Because I just logged into this machine as an administrator. This login is already existed. We already added the administrator login during the SQL Server installation. So SQL Server already having a login for this account. That's why you can log into this machine now. Imagine on like, I can log off from this administrator session. I can log in as other user session, something like some Karthik. I can log in as Karthik. Now you can see the name as Karthik here. If you open Management Studio, the name will be changed from administrator to Karthik. Computer name / administrator in case if you logged in through administrator session. Computer name / Karthik in case if you logged in through the Karthik session. Everyone will have their own sessions. But actually, computer name / Karthik, there is no login created for Karthik. So don't think like it is not asking password means don't think everyone can log into the SQL Server. No, this account is already added at the time of installation. Only this account can connect to the SQL Server, not other accounts. Clear? Any issues, any doubts here, please? Is it clear? Everyone, please, is it clear? Can you hear me?
Yep, it's clear.
Okay, that's fine. Right, okay, so that's why you can see the administrator here. Why? Because I just logged into this session as an administrator. So that's why automatically, okay, you can see the administrator name here. In case if I log off from the administrator and if I logged in as a Karthik or Shanmukh or some other different name, don't think like he can access the SQL Server. Why? Because we haven't created any login for Karthik or Shanmukh. So automatically the username also will be changed once you change the connection. Okay, now let me connect. Okay, right.
And Sean, just a question. You said we wouldn't be able to create more instances in one SQL server, right?
Like more default instances. Multiple default instances, not named instances.
Do we have to create more virtual machines for that? Like how nothing, it's gonna work if
nothing like that. See here, for one virtual machine, for one Windows server, we can install 50 instances. Okay. In that 50 instances, you can install one default instance and 49 named instances. So in case you want to install one more instance in the same machine, you can install as a named instance, okay? Not as a default instance. Why? Because default instance already occupied with the computer name.
Are we gonna change the instance name?
No, we cannot change the instance name.
Okay, we cannot.
Yeah, we cannot change the instance name. Once you choose default instance during the installation, okay, then once you choose the default instance or named instance, later I want to change this instance name, you cannot change it. There is other way, but not that is exactly changing the instance. I'll tell you how to change. See, when you change the computer name, automatically instance name also has to be changed. But the unfortunately in the SQL server, instance name won't change when you change the computer name. So in that case, I'll tell you how to change the instance name. Okay. But we cannot change from default to named instance to default instance. Got it?
Okay.
Yeah.
Would be better if you can just give a maybe example how, you know.
Default instance. So you are asking what is the difference between default and named instance?
No, not a difference. But can you show it as in live example? Like as in.
Yeah. I'll show you. I'll install one more instance, named instance.
Okay? Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
I'll show you. I'll show you. Don't worry about it. I'll install one more named instance. Okay. Right. Yeah, As of now, you found the difference. You got the difference between default and named, right?
Yeah.
Default instance will take the computer name. So computer name won't be duplicated. So that's why you can install only one default instance for the whole Windows machine. In case you need one more instance, no need to go for separate virtual machine again. You can install one more instance with your own name.
Okay.
You can install with your name also. You can install with Honey name. You can install with Sean name. Any name you want, you can install it. Okay?
Yeah, right.
Yeah, fine. Any doubts? Yes, Parmeshwar.
Sir, whenever we are installing SQL Server, that is mandatorily install for the default instance?
Nothing like that. It's not mandatory. For the first time also, you can go with the named instance. For the first time, you can go with the default instance. Nothing like that. There is no mandatory in choosing the instances. You can go with the named or default, anything. It's not compulsory. First time you have to install default instance, then only you can proceed for the named instance. Nothing like that. For the first time also, you can go with the named instance in case if you want. Okay, clear? Any issues, doubts, please?
Yes, sir. I have one doubt.
Yes.
Can you go to that window, sir? Connection window, SQL Server connection window.
Yes. Just 1 minute. Okay.
Yes. Yeah, please.
Yeah. This is the one you are looking for, or you want connect button?
Yes, sir. Connect button. Yes.
Yeah. Tell
just me. Click, sir. Just go to the reporting services or integration services, sir, in server type.
Okay.
Yeah, here I'm having the doubt, sir. What is the server name here, sir? Actually, you are saying for default instance, it is Windows.
So in case if you install reporting services, okay? Yes. In case if you install reporting services, okay, you can give the reporting services name here to connect. Usually the same name will be there. If you install reporting services on top of this instance, you can connect to the reporting services with the same server name. Okay. Mani, is it clear? In case if you install reporting services with the same server, while installing this server, you can have a chance to select the reporting services, analysis services, right? If you choose reporting services while installing this instance, then you can give the same name. What name you gave, the same name you can give here also to connect to the reporting services and analysis services.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay, fine. So once the connection is successful, you can see some options are highlighted here. Okay, this is the connect button. If you want to connect to one more instance, you can simply click on the connect button. Imagine I have three instances in the same Windows Server. Okay, you can connect multiple instances in the same Management Studio. It's not for no need to open or no need to install. Again, no need to install multiple Management Studios for each server. One Management Studio is enough to connect to all the instances. Got it? One Management Studio is enough to connect to all the instances. Again, if you install second instance, named instance. Okay, so again, no need to install the separate Management Studio for that. Why? Because you have already installed client. Client can be installed only once. No need to install multiple Management Studios. The meeting is going to close now. Okay, let me reopen the meeting. Please join immediately.
Sure.